Good morning, everybody. Orin J here with another War of the Visions video, and it is dark and early on Wednesday morning. The Baylo patch is here. You can see Big Man already on my home screen. Managed to off-banner him. Actually, I think you like get him as a new player. I don't know. Anyway, it's Baylo week. He's got a banner. There's some girl named Roth who's dropping. She's got some banners. We'll go over those, and we're gonna break this patch down like we always do. Now, when I'm doing my patch breakdowns, I often start in the daily purchase bonus. And I think we need to give special attention to the daily purchase bonus this week because the mystery, like the great mystery of the missing special shop, rolls into week 3. And so I'm going to talk about that right after I talk about the purchase bonus. Now, the daily purchase bonus itself, really good. Like, this is the best form of it, in my opinion, where if you do the whale bonus, the 5,000 paid, you get 100 Roth shards and 40 scrolls. This is my favorite version of that. And then the daily bonus is also great. You got some elemental material select tickets, scrolls, blossom shards. That's all great and fine. Like, I like what the daily purchase bonus is. Just once again, and I usually don't review the special shop this early in the video, it's a little bit out of order, but we've yet to get an update to the special shop. It's been a month now since they've added something new in the game to buy. Again, that continues to just kind of not make sense to me. I want to spend money. I enjoy supporting the game, and I really like when I'm given special deals in the special shop, and it is incredibly uncommon that this does not update for a month. I review the special shop every week. There are some weeks where I say, yep, guys, nothing new added to the special shop, but we've now gone through a collaboration starting and a Warrior of the Crystal Like Darkness starting. Now, oftentimes, to be fair, during Warrior of the Crystal week, that's not necessarily a week where we get things in the special shop, but going through a whole collab without getting anything in there is really awkward. I still just think it's bugged. So the purchase bonus is good. The incentive to purchase through deals just still doesn't seem to be there. And again, just, I'm not gonna harp on this in this video today, but the amount of people who've reached out to me saying, man, that like special discounted pack H, they just instantly buy that thing every time it comes up. Me too, I would love to pick it up this week, next week, when it just get the special shop working again, please. Now, it's not all bad on the bug front. Something to mention, there was an error in the picture for the, when we got all those tickets, there was a picture of like Starlight Elena and Esther on there, and they weren't supposed to be there, right? Like, they weren't in those tickets. And so they announced that we were going to get something in compensation for that, and that compensation has come through. So it is a 10 pull. Essentially, it's 10 single pulls that are guaranteed URs. So right here, we have the Road to Worldwide version EX UR guaranteed summon ticket. I'm gonna go ahead and claim those on this account right here, and I'll pull those at the end of this video, see what my baby J account right here gets. So that's really nice. That is a free 10 pull today that is all URs. So special shop still bug, that sucks. Compensation for that bug, on point. That's the kind of compensation we're looking for here in global. That's good compensation. All right, let's look at the banners. That's one of the things people really like to look at today. And Baylo did get himself a banner. Now, this is the Baylo banner, not the Baylo banner. Baylo being the real life person who was reincarnated as Baylo in this game. When you pull this, you're gonna get Baylo level 99 guaranteed, so that's great. You also get all the materials to level his jobs all the way to level 15. This is gonna be a big help for newer players like this account right here. He's somebody who could really help you in Earth Selection Quest. If you think about Earth Selection Quest now, you have Baylo, Mont, and Etra, who is farmable. You're well on your way to being able to clear a little Earth Selection action, at least push it pretty far. I really like this campaign, and I would love to see more campaigns for SR units, R units, whatever, like these lower rarity units that don't necessarily get a lot of hype. I really like supporting them like this, and not only just featuring them, but a give out, right? Like a way to level them to 99, a way to get all those materials that would be a crunch otherwise. Great job here, so that's really cool. Now, the banners. Here's your Roth banner, the regular one. Again, there's no pity bar for Warrior of the Crystal Dark units. Her drop rate is set to the 0.4%. You have Rulgia and Perrine, who are also boosted on here. The other Warriors of the Darkness are on here. They're just not boosted. So my thought would be this. If you're trying to get a Warrior of the Crystal that is not Roth, unless it's Rulgia or Perrine, this doesn't look like the week to do it. Perrine is really good. Still trying to like off banner 100 cost units, pretty rough. I will show you though, you do have your other ones on here. For example, like Risal's right there, Diallo's right there. They're just at the regular 100 cost rate. I don't know if that's intentional. I don't know if it's a bug. I think usually we get all of them at this like semi-boosted rate. So maybe submit a support ticket there. It's very possible that's another bug. We'll see. So there is some other banners to talk about. Now, your pity this week is going to be the coin pity. So if you're building up your coins, how do you want to do that? Well, here's a banner. It's a three-step MR plus guaranteed on the first two steps. First step is discounted, and third step, let me pull it up like this, will give you 40 shards guaranteed. Love this banner. If you're pulling for Roth, make sure you do this one. So if you do have to coin pity, which is just something that's on the table for sure with these 100 cost units, you're walking away with 80 shards from this banner no matter what. Her drop rate boosted on here, other Warrior of the Crystal drop rates not boosted on here. So it's a very slight nerf to drop rates if you're trying to off banner in exchange for 80 shards guaranteed. Well worth it. That's the banner I think you do. I think you also definitely pull on the 80 Mindspheres banner. Raph's, I have a hard time saying this chick's name. Raph's drop rate is 0.4%. So there, she's still boosted. You get your 80 Mindspheres and your pity medals. You can only do that one time. There's a paid step up, which is pretty standard at this point. We've seen this one a bunch of times. Yet two free pulls in the middle. You get URs guaranteed on 1, 3, and 5. 3 and 5 being those discounts with Roth shards at the end. So if you are throwing some paid Vizior at her, this is an option. Now there's a really interesting paid Vizior banner that I'm going to look at here in a minute. Here is a UR. This is not that one, by the way. Here's that UR guaranteed that comes with some pity coins. Again, I don't love this banner because it's only half of a pity, right? Like you're looking to build up your coins. This doesn't help you build up any coins. It's basically a 2% chance to pull Roth with a 5 shards guaranteed. Like that's the way to look at this one. So, okay. Now here's the one that I've seen getting talked about a little bit on like Discords already today. It's 3:30 AM. So the patch has been out for 30 minutes. This is a step up banner. Let's go over this thing. So it's three steps. There's a UR guaranteed on each step. Each step will cost you 2,000 paid Vizior. So it's 6,000 paid Viz. The deal here is you get a Darkness Festival unit guaranteed on step 3. So it guarantees you one of these units. You're going to get a Warrior of the Crystal Darkness. It could be Roth, it could be Perrine, it could be Diallo. You basically have a 1 in 6 shot at getting the one that you want. Now, I would say those three are my most premium three. I think they're the best three on here. I've yet to build Rugia yet. I'm working on him slowly on my other account, off-bannered him the other day. Risal is good. I've used her, but just not like those three are your premium ones, in my opinion. If you have none of them, this is three URs guaranteed. You're going to get one of these super premium units, and maybe you'll luck out into like Diallo or Roth. So I think it's tempting a lot of people. I've seen people pulling for this. If you do, I hope you get what you wanted. Good luck. If we look at the drop rates right here, Roth is boosted. So you do have a better chance of pulling her than anyone else. The other ones are not boosted. I would have liked to have seen them boosted as well. However, they are on here. You see Rugia, Diallo, Vega. They're here. They're just regular rates. Okay, so there you go. There's that one. Let's go to the Mog Shot. This is where you're going to be able to do your pitying today. Here's your coin shop. There's Roth to pity her for coins. Here's shards for the other units. Note that there's not a chance to pity any of the other Warrior of the Crystal Darknesses this week. That's not on the table. You're not going to be able to like build up pity and select Diallo or anything like that. Still, if you're building him, there are shards in here. If you just like throw some pulls at somebody and want to spend your coins. Otherwise, nothing really to mention in the Mog Shop. Let's go to the regular shop. You're looking at nothing new in the special shop, which, okay. Here's your War Crystal Festival Deluxe Shop. You have a unit training pack for 300 paid. Get you some elemental materials. I don't think I like that one. Training support pack. Don't like this one either. If you're really, really short on like these keys and you have extra paid viz to throw around, but I don't think so. And then there's the 1,000 paid viz for the UR scrolls that's here every week. So really nothing extra special in here, but there are paid things in Roth shop. We'll get there in a minute. Okay, something that is nice and something that, like, if you're pulling for Roth, you could definitely slow play it a little bit this week. We are once again getting the daily free pull ticket in the shop. This was added a few weeks back or a month back or something like that. I like this. I really like this. You're going to get 7 of these throughout the week. Then you also have your 2 days with login bonus pulls. There's 4 there. So you have 11 free pulls on the banner. That's a nice little bit of free pulls. So you can either save those up till the end and do them as a 10 pull. You can do them one at a time every day. Still, there's a chance right there of off-bannering something. So make sure you're picking that up. Get your Blossom of Paradise 4 gil. That's really great. So pick those up. Make sure you're getting those. Otherwise, you have like this Transcendence Unlocking Pack if you need a scroll. You have the Transcendence Pack, which I haven't liked in a while. Blossom Pack, if you really need blossoms, there's 3 of them for 1500. Unit Training Support Pack. Training Support Pack 2, 1. Yeah, these are like, again, I don't think there's anything in here that's tempting out my Vizior in any way. So buy the stuff for Gil and move on. Okay, Roth Shop. Now, here there's some other paid things. You have the Featured Summon Starter Pack. Here's a 10 pull for 300 paid. Really good deal. If you're spending some paid, this is a great place to do it. That'll get you a 10 pull on Roth's banner. Here's the Featured Summon Pack. It'll get you the 4,000 free Vizior worth of pulls for 3,000 paid. And you get the elemental materials and EXP cube, so that's just fine. And then this is back. Really, really like this one. I hope this is here for the rest of time. I would like to see, again, I would like to see the return of the 80 shard 2,000 paid pack for the unit that is boosted right now. But I also want to see this stick around forever because I actually think this is better than that. So you get 120 select ticket here, but it's a select ticket for any of the Warrior of Crystal Darkness. So if you've been trying to like slower build a Dialdo, this will really boost you on that path. It's 3,000 paid, which is a lot, but you're getting 120 select shards for 3,000 paid. I do like that one. And there it is. Okay, Roth shards for free every day. Make sure for free for 10,000. Yeah, the Gil shards are there. Pick those up. The job training pack, Roth, don't buy that. Like, just get these somewhere else. Here's your shards for the units if you need to pick them up for Vizior. Great. There's that. There's the shop breakdown. Now, let's do the part of this video that ever since I decided I was going to do this part in the middle, I've been looking forward to. I'm going to do my ticket pulls. So let's come in here. Let's go to ticket list. Here's my 10 pull with my Road to the Worldwide version EX celebration. It's actually something special that we got from Road to the Worldwide right here. I'm going to do it as a 10 pull. And this account needs everything. How's it? Wait, really? It's going to brown book me on a 10 UR Garrett? That needs to switch to a rainbow right now. Thank you. Thank you. Don't be brown booking me on a... Okay. Let me just talk about what I like about this so far. My thing I want the most... Okay, here's what I want. I want Dark Bahamut, regular Bahamut, Odin, Dark Odin, you know, those premium vision card Esper combos. That's what I'm looking for. Any light vision card would also be really nice. Okay, Trembling Heart. Okay. It's a new card. I'll always take new cards, but it's a bit of a miss. Culmination. Really, really good wind card. I'm just not playing wind. Here we go. Oh, yes. Okay, that's a huge W because this is, I have Valentine's Day Miranda. I don't like her card. If I ever wanted to go the job route, that's a big win for this account. Now, units. Okay, let's see. We're going to start with a new unit. Is this King Mont, right? Yeah, King Mont. That's great. So really happy to snag him, start building him up. That's definitely a slow build play for this account. So I'll begin working on him right away. 100 cost unit right there. I'll take all of those it wants to give me. Here's Uldoa. So I did pull Uldoa. Her Trustmaster is worth building. So there's that, especially on this account, actually. That Trustmaster is really worth building. You got to see a picture of it right there. It was the loincloth. Okay, come on. Hit me with the Esper Vision card combo right here. Omega, very good. So that's a good Esper. Omega's a good Dark card. That's a win. Dark is something I'm slowly building up. That is definitely, it's a long-term investment play, but it's a good one for Dark. Speaking of Dark, there's a Garvel dupe. Here we get, what is this, Oberon? No, oh, it's more, okay. All right, so more, again, not somebody I'm planning on building, but a new character to add to the roster there. Here we go, last vision card. Dark Bahamut. Just give me Dark Bahamut. You could do it, Gabe. Deliver. Ramu. Okay, a dupe of Ramu. Not the greatest. And then the last, the unit, is going to be Luel. So overall, not bad. I got a lot of new stuff. And the biggest wins here for me, actually, this was pretty good. So I get this vision card here that I wanted. I get a vision card Esper that I didn't have before. Definitely like that. King Mott, very good pull for this account. Again, it's more of a future investment, but a lot of these UR guaranteed pulls are future investments. I get a really good TMR in Uldoa's TMR. Yeah. Okay, very happy with that for this account. I'll do the ticket for my main account when I'm on stream later today, hanging out there. So thank you guys for watching. Good luck on your 10 free UR pulls. Good luck on any of the pulls you're doing on the banners today. Enjoy your Balo, and I'll catch y'all next time. Peace.